Not that I want to be negative, it's certainly not my intention, but I just wonder if our game has got the backbone or the stomach to see this through. We saw with the Western Force, they lasted 10 years, and then they were tossed out in very controversial circumstances. I was in Japan in 2016 when the Sunwolves played their first game at Prince Chichibunamiya Stadium after, in 2015, the national team beat South Africa, greatest upset of all time. There was huge support. And the Sunwolves, what's the Japan economy? I think it's eighth in the world, 127 million. They lasted 5 years. They won 9 games out of 61 games. Controversial. And in the end, they lost the vote. And I look at these restrictions that have been placed on the Moana Pasifika team, and there's nobody in the world of rugby that wants to see the Moana Pasifika and the Fiji Ndura team fail. We want it to be successful. So... they're not going to be successful if everyone hides all the players from them. As an example, Tunga Fasi and Tuanuku Afe are not starting at the Blues because Hodgman and Lolala are starting, but they've been re-signed, so Moana Pasifika doesn't have access to them. So Dane Coles has just re-signed for the Hurricanes through 2020. So what does that mean in game time for a Asafo Omoa? Under these rules, a Asafo Samoan, very proud young Samoan kid, can't play for Moana Pasifika.
Can play for the Blues, though.
He can play for the Blues. Via Fifita, there's another example. You know, I love Via as a player. I wish he gets more game time at the Hurricanes. A big, strong, aggressive player. Under these rules, he's not eligible for Moana Pasifika, but he's, what is he? He's somewhere back in the depth chart. So, you know, I'm not convinced that we are setting them up to be successful if we're going to just keep all the good players off them.
And so we brought Tumbai back in to talk about this because you're the coach of the New Zealand Under 20 team this year, right? So all of a sudden you've been in a tournament with all of this talent. The fact we've just heard where they're looking to pick players from, you've been across this conversation. When you look at this Moana Pasifika coming into Super Rugby next year, where do you see the challenges right now?
Well, first Buller and Kia ora tātou. I think the challenges, and this is where the Force had this challenge, the Sunwolves had this challenge, is you have to compete and you have to compete early. So if your flagship sinks in the bay in the first year, that becomes something that's pretty difficult to salvage. So for me, and I've probably got my coaching hat on, so probably I'm most hypersensitive around the roster, is how they're going to get a roster to play the Blues, the Crusaders and the Hurricanes in 3 weeks and move forward. That for me would be my biggest concern.
And this is where I disagree with you, Ken, because if you are in South Auckland and I'm the Blues or the Chiefs, I'm going to sign my kids for 10 years. This is now about competing for the money that's out there that's thin on the ground anyway. So I understand what you're saying about... I would prefer for them to say... and I don't know if bringing back some of the elder statesmen of Pacific Rugby who, towards the end, is helping Pacific Rugby, to be fair. You bring back Jerome Kino or something like that. What is he going to do for Pacific Rugby moving forward? So that's what I'm worried about. Nothing against Jerome. So, Ken, my problem is maybe we need to say, you know, Stephen Luatua, if you've played under 10 test matches for Auckland, for New Zealand or Australia or even England, remember we've got some Pacific Island boys up there, you can go back and play for Samoa, Tonga or Fiji, right? And then you can play for Moana Pasifika. I would prefer to see that. And then they're coming back to play for a reason and they can go and represent Tonga, Samoa and Fiji in the World Cup.
What do we want? Do we want the Moana Pasifika team to be a token team so we can tick the box? Or do we want Moana Pasifika to be like the Breakers basketball? Enter the competition as an expansion team in 2003. They won their first title in 2010, won 5 titles. The Brisbane Broncos, they entered the NRL in 1988, they won their first premiership in 1992. They've now won 6. The most successful of all the expansion franchises has been the Storm. They entered in 98, they won the competition in 99, and they won 6 premierships. My argument is, if we're fair dinkum about the Moana Pasifika, and I understand absolutely, JK, what you're saying. Of course the Blues are going to protect their players and the Chiefs are going to protect their players. But at the same time, we've made a commitment as a game to support Moana Pasifika. So do we want them to get flogged by 50?
No.
Because when they run out against the Crusaders, they've got to...
Melbourne was not in Sydney, right? That's what I'm saying. You put them in this competitive environment. There's not enough money out there for the
team. I agree, but those three
teams... So if they're in Samoa, I reckon it's different. Yeah, but those... I reckon you get a bit more grace, not as much competitiveness.
Yeah, but my point is about the quality of the roster.
Yeah.
Those three franchise teams that have been unbelievably successful franchise extension teams was because they were allowed access to quality players. So that, as you, obviously without game, you can't win without the ball. So you need quality players that can win the ball. So we'll go back to that argument about, well, you know, there are 20 Pacifica players in the Wallabies. There are 17 in the All Blacks. There's 37 of the elite Pacifica players that Moana Pacifica doesn't have access to. So are we now saying we can't have access to the other ones?
But if you pick them, is that going to help Samoa and Tonga at the next World Cup?
Well, I'm just saying, do we want Moana Pacifica to be competitive? Otherwise, are they going to follow the same route as the Force
but what's
and the Sunwolves after a few
years? But what's success, Ken? What I've understood is success is actually helping Samoa and Tonga become more competitive. You pick those players, that's not going to help anyone. So all I'm saying is if you want to help Pacifica, you want to help Samoa and Tonga, then make some rules. Five ex-All Blacks from Pacifica, you know, and 5 or 10 from the Pacifica. Make some rules where you go, actually, we can sustain this for the next 20 years. Well, it's no use picking off a Tongan fuss. He's going to do nothing for Tonga.
And, Tuboy, I don't have any concerns about where the Fijian team are coming in with this. The fact they've been playing in the NRC, the fact they've been playing at a higher level. They've had Andrew Forrest out of the Force, out of Perth, who's been supporting them and backing them. You look at the way that they've got their infrastructure, they've got support from World Rugby, they've got all the things that suggest that they're going to be competitive. Are we just going to have to be that little bit more patient when it comes to Moana Pacifica, in terms of the fact they are going to be behind the eight ball? OK, when do we expect them? Because you've just talked about teams, Ken, that took 6, 7, 8 years before they became elite. Not in year one, year two. That's going to be unrealistic. Reality is, though, I'm still concerned. How confident are you, Tabs, that they're going to be able to find players outside of New Zealand and Australia that can fill this roster and be not necessarily a champion team, but a team that can compete?
I think there's two things here. There's the chat about the pathway and the sustainability, and on the back of that is the strategic line with Tonga and Samoa. So there is the pathway of players coming from the islands into that platform. It will definitely help the World Cup programs or the international programs, because they'll have a platform to bring their players and play at a consistent level. That's really, really important. They've got to compete straight away because they get a first impression, and everybody were watching them when they played the Blues or the Crusaders at Eden Park or down in Christchurch, and so they've got to compete off the bat. And if that means that they've got to bolster it with some old dogs coming back, then I think that's going to be really important.
Don't get me wrong, I want them to be successful.
One of the things the Pacific Islands are famous for is their wayfinders. They've found a way, and I think this gives them a platform to find a way. There's no best practice so far, but they'll find a way.
And there are going to be massive decisions that come out, massive announcements you would expect over the next few weeks.